All right, something a little different today. We're going to work on my Norg 20-pound capacity dryer. Stopped working, stopped drying. Actually still works, but it stopped drying. But listen to this thing when I turn it on. Listen to all that. Okay, now when I shut it off, open the door here. Ooh, something's loose. All right, I pretty much know what this is. I've had this dryer part many, many times. It's probably... Oh, it's over 20 years old. We bought it new. So, all right, let me get tearing this thing apart, and I'll show you what the problem is. I think it's a pretty common problem. All right, don't forget to unplug the appliance first. That's probably the first thing you should do. All right, so I pulled it out a bit. Now I just open the hood here. And we'll start taking a look at what's going on in here. All right, so in this particular model, all you have to do is just take out two screws. There's one over here and one over here, and then the whole front just pulls forward. You got to take out the switch here. Just take these clips out, and it moves out of the way. Then you can get this open. All right, so you just lay the whole front of the dryer down. Pops right out. You just take them out of these little clips that are here. So I'm going to remove this out of the way. But I think the problem is right here. Yep, this fan, this is the blower fan that keeps the air circulating throughout the tumbler here. The shaft on here is worn out, or the plastic is worn out that connects the shaft, so we're going to find out here in a minute. Alright, so after removing many screws, now you can get this front piece off here. There we go. Okay, so as you can see, that's pretty loose. That's our problem. Yeah, if you can see here, this shaft is got like a bevel on it here where the I don't know if it's showing up too well, but the fan itself is supposed to have that same corresponding key, and you can see this one is round all the way, completely worn out. Over time these wear out, so I have to order a new squirrel cage fan. And that should be all I need to do. This thing should be back in working order again. Let me go get that ordered. All right, so the new part's here. Here it is. Look at that, made in USA even. Get this box open and get this thing installed. All right, so as you can see, that's got the bevel right there. That's got a key against that shaft in there. This should work a lot better than the other one. All right, let's get that installed. All right, there it is installed. Nice and tight. Now let's get this covers back on and we'll give it a try. Alright, all reassembled. Now we'll get the front face on here and put the hood back down and give it a try. Alright, plug it back in. Let's give it a try. Nothing. That's not good. Whoa, gotta close the door. Here we go. Let's try that. Oh, yeah. Oh, stop it. It should be nice and quiet. Perfect. All right. Much better. Yeah, it's too bad. I see a lot of these dryers get thrown away for this such a simple thing. So... if your dryer quits drying, but everything seems to be working, but it makes a really bad racket when it shuts down or when it starts up, more than likely it's that squirrel cage. It's easy fix, $33. All right. Thanks for watching.